So Daniel, you cover customer care in your classes mm-hmm. very often. Can you tell us what makes good customer care?
So obviously, just by the name, that you can tell that it's all about care. You need to show that you care, you need to make the customer feel special, that you really want to solve their issue, you want to do something for them, and in the end, going the extra mile is essential. Make them feel like they are the only one you are looking after. You've got no other work. You can do extra work for them personally. Even if you are busy, they will have to feel like they are the number one customer for you.
How do we deal with an angry customer or an upset customer?
Angry customers. Some people are very intimidated by angry customers, but you shouldn't be. They are angry, they are venting, they're not angry at you. They are angry because they have a problem that needs to be solved. And what you do is you try and solve that problem the best way you can, the way they want, but also more than they want. So you give them extra benefit after the problem is solved. You make sure that they're happy. You make sure they will come back to you personally. You have that relationship with you and also the company that you work for.
So is there a difference between customer service on the phone versus customer service in person?
Well, obviously there's a difference with the physicalness of it, if that's even a word. So on the phone, relatively simple, you have to give body to your voice. Your voice is the tool for creating concern, making sure you're listening as well as that, and doing it concisely, making sure you're conveying the message simply and well. When you meet someone, body language, the way you look, is essential too. So the way you dress, the way you deliver eye contact, the way you stand, as well as what you say, that would probably be the main difference.